you the very best of luck. Our next guest has sold millions of albums, duetted with the likes of Susan Boyle, Barbara Streisand. It's not Liza Minnelli.
I know, amazing. This is 11-year-old Jackie Evancho, who, since appearing on America's Got Talent last year, has had over 37 million YouTube hits, sold 1.5 million albums, and stunned us all with her performance on Saturday's Britain's Got Talent final.
Good heavens.
Oh, my goodness, Jackie Evancho joins us now. We were both saying earlier that when we watched that on Saturday, both of us had our jaws on the floor. We were like, because you were only 11 years old.
Yeah.
When did you discover you could do that?
I had just turned 8 years old, and I went to go see the movie Phantom of the Opera. And I loved the songs on the movie, and I sang the songs around the house. And my mom thought I was really good, so she asked me if I wanted to do a talent competition. Yeah. And I said yes, because I was excited. And I became first runner-up to a 20-year-old opera singer, which made me very excited.
Well, the thing is that with that competition, the little talent thing that you did, your parents thought, well, I didn't really think much of it. They knew you had a good voice, but it was only when you sang in public for other people, I think it was your grandparents, looked at each other and said, very much what I think the rest of the world has done, what is going on here? Do you realise what she can do? And that was the big surprise. Have you had training? Do you have to train your voice?
I think that I've had little training just to get me out of bad habits, but other than that...
What sort of bad habits are those?
Just making sure that you...
Smoking, drinking?
It was kind of just making sure that you have good breath control, yeah, and that when you sing, your voice isn't breathy and...
And that you sing the right words, yeah, in Italian. Presumably that takes a little bit of learning and practice.
But my main music teacher is my mom.
Oh, really?
She always teaches.
So is she a good singer as well, then?
I wouldn't say good singer. I wouldn't say great singer. She's a good singer.
I can see her. She's standing over here. Somewhere is she? There's the... No, she's running. She's making a run for it. So when you're away from home, you have to come away from home and leave all your pets and things behind, because you do have quite a lot of pets and stuff, don't you?
Yes.
What have you got?
I have 3 dogs, 2 cats, 2 guinea pigs, 1 lizard, 3 frogs, 3 ducks, and a crayfish.
So that's quite a few different beasts you have there, isn't it?
Who looks after them when you're away?
It's usually my dad and my brothers and sisters.
So then when you get home, presumably you have to pick up duties of looking after the pets, but presumably you also have to get back to studies as well.
Yeah.
Do you have to go back to school?
Yeah. Yeah, but I love school, and when I go home, it's going to be one of the last days of school, which makes me sad, because I love school and I love all my friends, but on the last day of school, it's fun.
You've got school holidays coming out, the big summer holidays. And I suppose in your summer holidays, are you working? Are you doing any concerts and things?
Yes, I'm working, but in July, I'm going on vacation, which is exciting.
So some time off. See, that's brilliant already at 11, you're looking forward to downtime. I just think it's amazing. Because already you've got a career that a lot of people out there who enjoy singing, well, they can only dream of. You've already duetted with Barbara Streisand, Susan Boyle. What's that been like for you? Did you know who they were before you met them?
I did know who they were when I started singing, before I started singing, actually. And I didn't actually sing with Barbara Streisand duet and Susan Boyle. What happened was we sang in different studios.
Yeah, that happens a lot, doesn't it?
And David Foster put our voices together.
Yeah.
But it ended up really good. And
what is your dream now? What do you want to do?
I would love to stand on the red carpet with people like Christina Aguilera and...
So pop people?
Yeah. Well, I mean, just that kind of feeling on standing on the red carpet with other famous people.
Yeah. What about performing? Is there a place that you've thought, right, this is where I want to sing? Oh yeah, definitely. You've definitely got an idea.
Where?
I would love to sing at the Madison Square Garden.
Yeah, in New York.
And do you think this is the kind of music that you'd like to carry on singing, or would you like to try different types?
I think I am going to carry on with this kind of singing, because I was never really good with pop, and I love listening to it, and I sing it around the house sometimes, but I'm never good at it, and it's kind of like, Jackie, you know, just be quiet and stick with what you know.
Yeah. Stick with what you know. Well, it's a pleasure to have you here. You stunned us all on Saturday when you sang, much as you did America as well. And now, of course, it'll be the rest of the world. This is the album, and you're going to sing for us at the end of the show.
Yeah.
What are you going to do for us? Essendorma?
I guess so, yep.
That sounds like a good plan.
Do you just love what's happening to you at the moment? Are you having a great time?
I just love what's happening to me, and it's a great... I'm always having a great time.
Brilliant.
Oh, you're lovely. It's lovely to meet you. Thank you very much for coming.
Coming up, the one and only Liza Minnelli confesses all to me. Very exciting. See you after the break.